Westinghouse. Westinghouse Studio One. Westinghouse, the name that means sureness. Whether it's on vacuum cleaners for America's homes or electric trolley coaches for our cities. Whether it's a product for your home or your business or your farm or your factory, you can be sure if it's Westinghouse.
Oh, I know you're not. You never are. But you look it. I'm going to shake like a puppy now. Anything around here can't stand a wetting?
No.
Good. Ooh. There.
Take off your sweater. You're going to catch cold.
No, I can't. I've got a turkey shriveling in the oven. I just dashed over here to pick up my cake. Is it ready?
The angel food?
Mm-hmm. Frida, you know you'd look 5 years younger if you cut your hair and gave yourself a permanent. They have those do-diggers that
Jeffy,
you clamp in your hair.
Jeffy, deliver your cake. She left here an hour and a half ago.
Well, she must have eaten it.
What's the matter?
Oh,
Larry's pies. Excuse me.
Oh.
Custard pie is his favorite. He used to be able to eat a whole one.
Frida, you know I wouldn't have missed that boy's homecoming for anything in the world. It's just that Harry's Uncle Fred and Aunt Olga, you know, the ones in the poodle clipping business. Now, if that isn't ridiculous, they're driving through. Naturally, they would have to stay for dinner. On a Saturday night, too. I understand the whole crowd, the whole town is going to be at the station. Well, there's my cake. Nettie Clark. Deliver at 4:30.
Oh, Nettie, I'm sorry. Jessie must have forgotten it.
Oh, she's probably silly with excitement. What with her brother coming home from Korea and all. How long has it been, Frida? Seems like more than 2 years.
It's been three.
Three? Well, just imagine. Where does the time go? Well, I've got a turkey to baste. Oh, I'm glad for you, Frida. You must be very happy. Now, you give that boy of yours a big hug for me and tell him hello.
I will.
I'm going to send him over a turkey leg tomorrow if I can keep it away from Harry's Uncle Fred. He eats like a fury. I might just as well not have this thing the way it's coming down.
I'm sorry about the cake, Nettie.
Now, forget it. You've got enough to worry about. Oh, good heavens. I forgot to pay you. Isn't that just like me?
Give it to me another time.
It's a dollar and a quarter. Will you look at it coming down? Well, I'm going to run before I drown.
She'll mail you a check. I forgot how much the apple pies were. You'll have to call her.
Take off your shoes and socks, honey.
And the Bennetts want to know when you're baking donuts again. I said probably Tuesday. Is that okay?
Mm-hmm.
Hi.
Hi. You awfully wet?
Oh, it's soaked. Look at my hair. It's all a mess. What time is it?
Now catch your breath. It's 6:15. Give me a second. You forgot Mrs. Clark's cake.
Oh, I know. I almost knocked her over just now. I'm sorry. I left it on the kitchen table, especially so I'd remember it, too. Mom, do you think there's anything in those memory courses they advertise in the movie magazines? Your memory can be your salvation.
I don't know, dear.
I think I'm going to send for one. Mom, did you check and see whether Larry's train's on time?
Yes, it's on time.
I'm going to wear my new dress. I don't care if it blows up a hurricane. Golly, Mom, I'm so excited. I wonder what he'll look like. I bet he's grown. Do you think he has? He was only 18 and a half when he left. Boys grow till they're 21, don't they?
Some do.
Phil Bennett's 23 and he's still growing. He's weird, though. Mom, do you suppose Larry's really all better? I mean, what did he sound like on the phone?
I told you, dear, it wasn't a very good connection.
Did he sound weak?
No, he sounded all right.
You know, I've been thinking, Mom, I mean, about what to say to him and all. I've decided not to ask him about anything. I mean, about what it was like being missing in action or anything. I think that's the best policy, don't you? I mean, if he wants to talk about it, I'm just going to nod. I was wondering, Mom, do you think if he starts to talk about it, I should even change the subject?
I wouldn't worry about that now, dear.
I wonder what those army hospitals were like. I bet they're real depressing.
I don't know if they are.
What's the matter, Mom?
Nothing.
You look funny. Aren't you happy?
Of course I'm happy, baby. Now you run on up and change. I don't want you to catch cold.
Okay. Mom, are you nervous? Oh, well, now, if that isn't the silliest. You mean because of that crowd at the station? Well, they're just...
Jeffy, your father's coming here.
Oh, no, Mom.
Called me an hour ago. I haven't talked to him in 1 year, and he called me an hour ago. He wants to go with us to the station to meet Larry. I couldn't say no. It's his right. Jesse, he didn't even ask me how I was.
Why does he have to come here? Why can't he go straight to the station?
Jesse.
Mom, I don't understand. This was supposed to be a happy thing. I've been fluttering in my stomach for days. Why does he have to?
He's Larry's father, Jesse.
He's my father, too, and I don't even know him to say hello to anymore.
Don't say that.
Mom, I was planning on having fun tonight. Larry's coming home. A few months ago, we thought he was dead, and now he's coming home. This isn't the time for strangers.
Jesse.
I don't know what to say to him.
Well, I can't give you the words, baby, but they'll come. Now run on up and get ready. Hmm?
Bad night. My feet are probably...
It's all right. The rug's wet already.
Oh. Well, I didn't want
to... No, it's quite all right. Take off your coat, Sam.
You're looking well, Frieda.
you like to sit down?
Yeah, I would. Thanks.
How have you been, Sam? You look thinner.
Oh, fine, fine. Well, you know me. I very rarely get sick. Oh, you got new curtains, huh?
They're a year old.
How's Jessie?
Jessie's fine. She's growing up fast now.
Mm-hmm. Where is she?
In her room, putting on her new dress and wondering what she's going to say to you.
Oh, now, Frieda.
I'm sorry. It's not easy.
No. No, it's not easy.
I heard about the bacon.
You're not working too hard, are you? I mean, it wouldn't be so good if you were working too hard.
We're getting along fine.
That's good. Did you speak to Larry? How'd he sound?
All right.
Yeah? Where was he?
California somewhere.
California. It'd be good to see him again. You still got his butterflies? I was sure he was dead, Frieda. I could feel it. You know what I mean? I went out in the backyard one night in my pajamas. Oh, I don't know. It must have been 3 or 4 in the morning. And I cried. I haven't cried since I was 8 years old. But I cried then. My nose got sore, just like when I was a kid. I never told you about that. It was about 4 months before I left here. I had to come here, Frieda. I heard Larry was alive, and I heard he was coming home, and I just had to come. Can you understand that?
Yes, I can understand that.
Well, I'm his father.
I said I can understand.
Does he know about us?
No, not yet.
How are we going to tell it to him?
I don't know.
What's to tell? Nothing. Can't even tell myself. Larry, your mother and I were married 25 years, and then we couldn't stand being together anymore. My side of it. All the words I ever found. Yeah, that's what I'm going to tell him.
I don't have any side.
What time is it?
Why didn't you ever call?
It's getting late.
What did she have to do with all this?
Please, Frieda.
You might as well have taken her arm and snapped it in two across your knee.
Stop it, will you?
Yes, we'll deliver tomorrow afternoon.
Hello, Jessie.
Hello.
You look grown up.
Yes.
I'm 16. 5 o'clock.
Yeah, I know.
Thank you, Mr.
Well, it's good to see you, Frieda.
Oh, I rented a car. It's outside. It's only two blocks, but I thought the kid would get a kick out of it. You know how they are.
Anything in the world. I'm happy for you, Frieda. Sam.
How are you, Nettie?
Thank you, Nettie. It was very nice of you.
Well, Mrs. Benson.
Oh, hello, Mrs. Fitch.
We only have a minute, but Walter and me, we wanted to tell you how happy we are about your boy.
Thank you very much.
Let's pause for a moment and turn to our Westinghouse program and Betty Furness. Try this on your refrigerator.
Yes, see if you can do this with your refrigerator. Find anything that you want blindfolded. Well, it's easy if you have this exciting new Westinghouse food file refrigerator because it gives you a special place and a special cold for every kind of food. For instance, suppose you want a Coke. Well, it's right here in this exclusive Westinghouse beverage keeper, where you can file over a dozen Cokes and other beverages and keep them perfectly chilled and ready to enjoy. Then, suppose you want the butter. Well, it's right up here in the butter keeper, kept firm but soft enough for easy spreading. Then, how about a nice juicy steak for dinner? Well, there's no groping around because it's right here in this exclusive Westinghouse meat keeper that's located right under the freezer and has a special circulating cold that keeps fresh meats fresh days longer. The eggs? Well, they're right over here on the door, and there's a full two dozen of them. Now, each one of these egg keepers holds six eggs, and you can tilt it like this or lift it right out. Isn't that convenient? And how many times have you had to search for cheese in your refrigerator? Well, this Westinghouse food file refrigerator has a special place just for cheese. It's this exclusive cheese file right here, where your cheese is kept at just the right cold so it's at the right temperature and the right humidity. Now, I know that you don't go around your kitchen blindfolded, but isn't it wonderful to be able to know just exactly where everything is whenever you want it? That's why I know you're going to love this brand new idea in refrigeration, the Westinghouse food file refrigerator. Of course, it's completely frost-free, and that means no defrosting in the freezer and no defrosting in the refrigerator ever. Go and see this exciting new food file refrigerator tomorrow, available only at your Westinghouse dealers. And remember, you can be sure if it's Westinghouse.
We return now to Westinghouse Studio One and the death and life of Larry Benson.
Dad, you've lost weight, Skinny.
Oh, it's funny. I knew when I came home you'd have a stuffy nose. You always do when you feel like crying. Here, Mom, boy.
Jess, you little pipsqueak, you're all grown up. Miss America.
You know what? It's a funny thing. All of a sudden, it feels like I've never been gone. I'm hungry. Wait a minute. Oh, hello, Mrs. Fitch. Well, what's the matter with her?
I don't know.
I'd like to go home.
Now, you wait a minute.
Well, nothing changes, even the way it smells. It's the last time I'm going to lug you ton of bricks. Well, what do you know? I've grown nearly 2 inches. Look at this, Dad, 2 inches at least. You bet me a dollar I wouldn't grow more than one, remember? Fork it over.
Who are you? I said, who are you? Well, what's the matter? Haven't you got ears?
Dad. Damn. I just walked into the house 10 seconds ago. What are you playing games for? In the car, nobody opened his mouth. What's wrong?
What's your name?
What's my name? Mom, what's the matter with him?
I'll tell you what's the matter with me. What are you trying to do to us? Busting in here out of nowhere. Acting as if you were our son.
Acting? But, Dad, you gotta be joking. What are you saying? Mom, what does he mean? I don't understand.
No, you don't understand. Where's my boy?
You're crazy.
Answer me!
Damn.
He'll answer. He'll answer or I'll break his neck.
Sam, stop it. Go upstairs, Jesse.
Jess. Well, you haven't even said hello.
Now, that's enough of that. You come back here. Listen to me.
If you shout, I don't think I'll be able to stand it.
I can't stand it now.
I beg of you, please.
Mom, for heaven's sake, what is it?
Come inside. Take off your coat, Sam. Where to find the humidor?
Well, that's where it's always been. You never let Dad keep it on the table because he always spilled tobacco.
How do you know that?
How do I know it? Well, what do you want me to say? I've seen it 1,000 times. I prayed for 3 years I'd see it again. Mom, what are you trying to do?
I don't know.
Well, I'm back in my own home and everybody's staring at me like I'm a bug on a pin. Look, you got to tell me what's going on.
You walked over to some woman in the station and said hello to her. Who was it?
It was Mrs. Fitch.
And who is Mrs. Fitch?
She was my 7th grade school teacher. She gave me a D in conduct. Who do you think Mrs. Fitch is? Look, you've got to tell me what's going on.
Freda.
Oh, Mrs. Benson, I'm certainly sorry to trouble you. I know it's late.
Oh, no trouble at all, Miss.
Well, Bert and I were stretching our legs after the rain. Mind it is nice and fresh out. Well, anyway, I was telling Bert that I'd like to order some of those little brownies you make.
The ones with the almonds? And the funniest thing, just after I finished telling him, we were passing by here, so I thought I'd ring the bell.
I'm sorry, Mrs.
I'd like to order a dozen. I'm expecting the children tomorrow, and I have the thing in the house and Sammy Fletcher day.
I'm very sorry, Mrs. Potter. I couldn't possibly have you before you tomorrow morning.
Oh. Well, if you can't, you can't, I guess.
Thank you very much, Miss Potter. Good night.
Now you listen to me!
Mom, what was that? What was she talking about? Are you selling cakes to the neighbors?
Wait a minute. Who are you to be asking that?
Are you?
Why do you call me Mom?
Why do I call you Mom? Well, that's all I've called you for 21 years.
Look at me. Where do you come from? How do you know us? You're going to have to answer my questions now because I'm not going to be able to ask very many. I stood in the station tonight waiting for my son. He didn't get off the train.
What are you saying?
It wasn't very easy to stand in the station. Who are you?
I'm Larry Benson.
No.
And I'm back in my own home after 3 years and I feel like it's coming down on my head.
Wait a minute, where do you think you're going?
Sam, please.
I'm going to take him to the south door.
Sam, please.
What's the matter with you?
I don't know, but he's frightened, Sam.
Wait.
He's frightened. Larry's room. What?
I don't know. Tear it out of him.
No, Sam, please. Let him stay.
I don't stand in my way, Frieda.
I will stand in your way.
Don't
let him stop. I have no rights in this house.
Sam, you hear me? Take your hands off my mother.
Sam!
My hand where I slapped him, it stings. He just looked at me.
What did you want him to do?
Frieda, where's Larry?
I don't know.
How can you stand there and say, I don't know, like somebody was asking you the time or something? What are you made of, anyway?
My insides are twisting and turning so hard it hurts. I never felt such a pain. Where's Larry?
Now don't say I don't know. I'm talking about a boy. I want to know where Larry is. I want to know now.
I want to know it too, Sam.
Frieda, look, there must be some way. I mean, if we sat down with him, if we were quiet.
He doesn't know. Did you see his face when you hit him? You were his father.
He's crazy.
Sam, go home.
No.
It would be better. I can't think with you here.
I said no. Oh, I can't go now, Frieda. I'll sit up in the chair, anything. And then tomorrow we'll call the army. We'll make inquiries. We'll try. Oh, please, Frieda.
I wonder if he liked the butterflies.
What are you talking about?
I'm afraid, Sam. I'm afraid. And there isn't anyone to make me not afraid anymore.
They're beautiful.
It takes a lot of running. I mean, sometimes you have to chase them. I don't know why I came in here. Maybe you could understand it. You see, this was my brother's room and...
You remember how you used to scream and run to Mom and I'd put him on the pins?
How did you know that?
It doesn't hurt him a bit.
But you couldn't know.
You used to call me a murderer.
No, that's not true. I used to call Larry a...
What are they doing to me, Jess? They don't know me. I'm their son and they don't know me. They don't want me here. You gotta help me, Jess.
Your face is all red where he hit you.
Why did he hit me? He never hit me before in his life. It's almost like he's not my father.
It's almost like he's not my father.
Why?
I don't know him anymore. He left us a year ago.
No, that's not true. What do you mean? Tell me, what are you trying to say? He didn't leave. He didn't. I've got a family here.
For a moment and turn to our Westinghouse program and Betty Furness. Put yourself in this picture.
They seem to like each other, don't they? And of course, they like the clear and lovely music coming from that handsome portable radio and the juicy steak charcoal broiling on that smart barbecue grill. And you're going to like this exciting summer bargain special because, listen, this handsome Westinghouse radio with the smart carrying case, these batteries, and this useful grill are worth a total of $44.80. But they're yours all together for only $34.95. You save $9.85. Now, this deluxe personal portable is especially adapted for traveling because it has an automatic battery conserver that takes over and makes the batteries last longer. Now, here we've opened the radio for you to show you the long life batteries installed. But suppose you're in the country, where only flashlight batteries can be obtained. Well, a simple adjustment lets you install them like this. And, as usual, your favorite stations come in loud and clear. What's more, this smart carrying case is open here in the front, so you can leave the radio right in it. Then let me show you how easy it is to use this clever barbecue grill. You just pull the handles out like this, then the charcoal goes down there in the fire pail. There's no danger of starting a forest fire. Then when you want to turn your steak over, don't use a fork. Just turn the grill, right like that. Now remember, this deluxe Westinghouse personal portable, together with the candy carrying case, the batteries, and the grill, are yours for only $34.95. And then, for just a few dollars more, you can get this exclusive PortoPack power supply unit that adapts the portable to AC house current. So, see your Westinghouse dealer tomorrow. Take advantage of this really exciting summer bargain special while it lasts. And remember, you can be sure if it's Westinghouse.
We return now to Westinghouse Studio One and the death and life of Larry Benson.
I must have fallen asleep. Are you all right?
Yes, I'm all right.
Spent the night thinking. All night. That's a very hard thing to do. You think about everything that ever happened in your whole life.
Coffee's on. It's left over.
I'm trying to think about what to do. It's slipping out of my head. I don't know what's the matter with me. Can't seem to think anymore.
Would you like something to eat?
Hmm? No, thanks. You know the only thing I could think of? I'm going to call the army.
It's Sunday.
All right, so it's Sunday. What do? Shut down the whole army on Sunday? Well, there must be some place we can call. That's what phones are for. Look, how long do you think I can live with this thing? I've been sitting out in that chair and I've been... All right, it's Sunday. What are we supposed to do, go to church?
Coffee's ready, sit down, Sam.
I don't understand you. What are you thinking about?
Like I know him.
What's the matter with you? You're not making sense.
I know him, Sam. He came into my room last night. I was crying. Put his hand on my head. Felt just like Larry's hand. I didn't cry anymore. That's insane, isn't it?
I don't know. I don't know what's insane or what isn't.
Don't call today, Sam. Please, not today.
Where is he?
He's in his room.
It's not his room, Peter. It's Larry's room.
Hello?
Now, there's some questions I want to ask you.
But maybe you'd like...
Come back here. It's like talking to a rock.
Coffee's getting cold.
Oh, my coffee's getting cold. That's a fine thing to say now. Why don't you ask me what time it is? Watch.
No, It doesn't belong to you.
Look, Fred. Larry's picture.
What are you going to do?
What do you think I'm going
to
do?
No, Sam, please let me talk to him. I know how.
I know how, too. He had Larry's picture in his bag and never even opened his mouth.
But, Sam, he couldn't. Don't you understand? He couldn't. You can't shout at this boy. He won't hear you. Sam, let me talk to him. Please let me.
Ask him about Larry's picture.
I will.
Ask him about the picture.
I will, Sam. Grass smells sweet, doesn't it? I used to like to lie in it and read. Sometimes I'd fall asleep. I haven't done that in 3 years now. Hedges are a little ragged. You have to keep after them.
Mom, why did Dad leave here?
I don't think we should talk about that now.
I want to know.
Well, I don't think I can answer you.
He doesn't have the right.
You can't talk about the right or the wrong of it. You don't know. Sometimes things like this happen. No one knows why. You can love someone very much.
For 25 years.
It's only time. Feel the grass.
Yeah, it's cool. It hasn't been quiet before. I don't know quite how to behave.
I know.
There's so many things. I never thought when I came home I'd be frightened.
I don't want you to be frightened.
Why don't you call me something? It's like I've got no name. Say Larry. Say, son, say, dear, why don't you call me something?
Dear. Who is this?
Oh, that's Danny Holmes.
Danny Holmes?
Yeah, I keep his picture.
Who is Danny Holmes?
He's my friend. I wrote you about him so many times, don't you remember?
Yes, I remember.
So many things about Danny that were really remarkable. You know, like the harmonica. I wrote you about that, how he used to play it. At night in the hills, you could hear it everywhere. It was a good sound. Lieutenant never shut him up because the guys liked it so much. I told you.
Yes, you told me.
Danny Holmes. He was my brother. Does that sound funny?
No.
Well, that's what I felt. I really felt he was my brother. See, we were together from the beginning. He always wanted to talk about home.
Where was Danny's home?
I don't know. I don't think he had one, not since he was a little kid, about six, I guess. His folks died. I don't know where they lived. He didn't talk about it very much. Bummed around, I think. Maybe that's why I used to want to hear about my home so much. You know, about you and Dad and Jess and everybody. I remember one time we were sitting in a truck riding up to Jean, and I told him about the hayride we went on out to Cat's Creek. That was fun. Do you remember? Well, I don't know. Sitting in the truck reminded me of it, the bumping and everything, so I told it to him. He cried. All the guys looked at him. And later on, he told me that he'd never been on a hayride.
What else did you tell him?
Oh, I don't know. Everything. Everything I could think of. What it's like to have a family, the things we do together, how much we love each other. Oh, Mom, you should have seen his face when I tell him about the house. When I showed him the pictures of you and Dad and Jess and everybody. I even showed him the pictures of my seventh grade class. You know, the one with me sticking my tongue out and Mrs. Fitch wearing the same nutty hat she had on yesterday and looking like she wanted to swat me once. He loved us so much. He'd sit and he'd think, but somehow he'd be far away. He was always grabbing a blade of grass and chewing on it when we talked. Like the taste, he said.
Lots of people like the taste of grass.
Yeah. He never got tired of us, Mom. He'd ask me to tell it to him again and again about the house, the town, the people we knew. About all the things he never had. We were lost in the hills that time. We hid in a little cave for 9 days. It smelled like earthworms in there. It was so small we couldn't move. But we'd lie there and I'd tell Danny about the way we lived for hours. And you know, it's funny, but that's the happiest I ever saw Danny, those 9 days. It's like when he listened to me, he finally belonged somewhere.
Where is Danny now?
Somewhere. I don't think I could find it. It's in a valley between two big hills. He died in my arms there. I dug up the ground with my hands and I buried him. And then it started to rain. I wandered off into the hills again. It was like I died, not Danny. They found me. I don't know when. It was a long time. They said I was hysterical. I had Danny's picture in my pocket, and that's all I had. He was my brother.
Danny Holmes. Larry's dead. He buried him.
Larry's dead.
Way you do. Why, you could pack some of those cakes in those little cellophane bags, and I'm sure the stores would buy them. You could call them Mrs. Benson's Cakes, or something like that. I hope they're fresh. 11, 12. That one looks a little underdone. Oh, thank you. They get a little overdoughy when they're not quite done. Oh, thank you. Now, how much is that?
Oh, they're 15 cents a piece.
That's $1.80, right? Well, I must be going. I have to be at church early. The choir. Mr. Peabody has a feeling that... well, goodbye. Thank you.
Dad, why does...
I'm not your father. My son is dead, do you hear? My son is dead! Well, what are you looking at me like that for? You buried my son. I don't know you. Now, you've got to understand this now. You've got to. Tell him so he knows, will you? He's standing there, and I can feel him with my hands. And Larry's dead.
I can't hear you anymore.
Larry's dead! Get him out of here! Get him out!
Who am I? Doesn't somebody know me?
My brother, I want him back. Look at him. He's so like Larry.
Jesse.
Don't listen, I'm trying to tell him.
I know, darling, I know.
Sam, you're going to have to listen to me now because this is so important and I'm not going to say it very well.
I don't want to hear it.
Sam, look at me. Look at me, Sam. Somewhere I've got to find the words. It's about Larry. Do you remember him?
Oh, Freda, for heaven's sake.
Because I do, Sam. Like he was here. Every move he made, every hair on his head. The joy of watching him grow. The hopes I had for him. The hopes, Sam, that's the thing. You have a son. And you give your whole life giving him your love and so that he can be good. And you make mistakes and you wonder and you worry. And then all of a sudden you realize he is good. Decent and gentle and getting ready to be a man. And then you know everything's going to be all right with him. And then you can really start to hope for the wonderful things. And that's the importance of it, Sam, the hope.
Stop it, will you, Frieda?
One day in a strange valley, your boy runs with another boy, just like him. A friend, almost a brother. And death chooses between them and finds Larry. And you think that's the end of hoping. But it isn't. Oh, Sam, it isn't. Sam, how lucky we are. Her son came home to us. Look at him, how he sits there. So like Larry. So like every boy. What's the difference between any of them on the earth? Name it, Sam. Name it. I'll send him out of this house. Larry shared his whole life with this boy. Our son gave us to him because he loved him. But Larry gave, we can't take away. Oh, look at him, Sam. He needs so to be loved. He needs a father. Can't you see that? He wanted us so much that he became our son in his own mind. Oh, Sam. Please, he needs us terribly. I want to hope for our son again. Sam, we need to be a family.
Welcome home, son.
Sam, I love you.
Thank you.
looking at us. Smile at them, Jesse. Your father and your brother have come home.
Betty Furness to ask, where were you on the night of July the 14th?
Yes, remember how hot it was? So hot you couldn't sleep a wink. Well, be prepared for those hot, humid nights and days ahead with this wonderful new Westinghouse room air conditioner. It keeps you so cool in summer, it freshens the air all year round and warms it in winter, too. It gives you 10 different comfort zones. You just push a single button on this exclusive comfort control panel, and you change the weather. What's more, this fiberglass filter cleans the air of dust and pollen. That's a wonderful comfort if you suffer from asthma or hay fever. And the Westinghouse is draft-free, too. We put these ribbons on here just to show you. You can turn these three grills in any direction, like this, like this. You control the flow of air so that you never feel a draft. Look for this sign. See your certified Westinghouse dealer. You can own a Westinghouse room air conditioner for as little as $3.25 a week after a small down payment. And remember, you can be sure if it's Westinghouse. This amazing new Westinghouse four-way fan. Use it on the table or as a hassock fan for all-around circulation. Use it in the window to drive the hot air out. See this new four-way Riviera fan at your Westinghouse dealers.
Studio One originated live from New York City.